You're back. You sure you still want me here, callers and all? Not much for waiting around with a bomb around my neck. You did. Looks like even the old world can't keep you out when you've got a mind to get in. So, I just rasp out some words and the vault opens? That woman, the Starlet, she didn't build this place. Why would the builder do that? I know. The sealed doors, the security. It's almost a fortress. Think that's why we're being ordered to come here and crack it open? Love makes people do strange things. Won't argue that. It can drive you crazy sometimes if you can't connect. If they loved each other, and they were together, I suppose that's all that mattered. But she's in that side room, dead, because the casino wouldn't let her leave. Who knows where he is? All right. If you go down there, are you prepared? What if you don't come back? I just wanted to make sure you're ready. When you go down there, that may be it for us. We won't be needed anymore. The one who made these collars, he'll follow you down there. And he won't let you leave. He's not one for sharing. Never was. I can't let him leave here. Look, you've done so much, and he's not gonna show himself until you go down there. I can't let go. Every time I've thought about it, I've lost him so many times. He needs to die. What happened here with us? He's done so much worse. You have to promise me. Promise me you'll deal with him. If I see him, I... All right, I'll... But I'll need to leave this floor. He'll pick up my collar and... Never mind. Let me get the vault open. Begin again. But know when to let go. Sounds like you. The quick scribe jumped over the lazy paladin. Begin again, but know when to let go. Thank you.
Traps down there. Another security system. Hiding? Hardly. Trapped. You think you were the first one to unlock the casino door? No, I didn't. With other hands, other bodies. After that, the casino wouldn't let go. Once I was locked in, no way out. Until your Pip-Boy signal came to life in the villa. Then things change. And here you are. You speak as if your fingers have never touched the keys of a Robco terminal. No machine is foolproof. They are designed to obey us. The Pip-Boy's operating system has vulnerabilities, advantages to those who've studied its construction, even superficially. It's just a machine, though. Its real vulnerability is who wears it. And that's how you were caught. Proud that you have one? I can hear the superiority. That thing on your wrist, it's a convenience. It tells you where to go, what to do. Dulls your brain. It may have helped you find the Sierra Madre broadcast, but it's just as much a crutch today as it was in the old world. Curious? You must be. We have time now that you've done your work. And our interactions have been too one-sided, even for my tastes. What do I want? Weapons, security, a citadel of my own. The Madre is all these things. It's a fortress, a weapon, a chance to begin again. Once I unlock its archives, I can carve the Mojave into any shape I choose. The cloud is unique in my travels. Its proximity to the Sierra Madre isn't a coincidence. Right now, it protects this casino, preserves it. It can be used to preserve other old world relics and cleanse them at the same time. And as much as I've researched hologram technology, the big empty facility was clear. Only the Sierra Madre got holograms working properly. The holograms here kill trespassers. That's what I want. Dump one of those emitters in the middle of any battle, there's no defense. It's like holding light in your hands. Can't fight it. Only watch it burn. Just one's a portable army. Arm it. Anyone stands against you, dies. No, there's one last thing I want from the Sierra Madre. It's bounty. The machines that fill its streets, its corridors. They provide almost anything. Perhaps in the pre-war era, they were commonplace, things to dismiss. Now they are far more valuable. You know it. They helped keep you alive. Sources of food, supplies, medical assistance, ammo, make more collars, even print currency. Make a nation. The cloud allows me to wipe the slate clean. Collars ensure cooperation. Holograms, defense. The vending machines provide everything else. The Sierra Madre can kill nations and build them, using its technology with the right applications. You think I'm a murderer? If I was, I'd have set off your collar long ago. The collar ensures compliance, encourages cooperation. Think about it. Would you truly have gotten into the casino without those collars? No. Human nature is against us, always. Did you know that I had to keep adjusting the collars, keep changing the rules to make this moment possible? Every time, even with collars clutched at their necks, they would betray each other, kill each other to get inside the Sierra Madre. It was insanity. They could have had it all. It was so close. And they kept turning on each other, again and again. Cracking the Sierra Madre was difficult, but cracking greed, that was more difficult. So the dead man switches went in. When your life is tied to another's, sacrifice and cooperation, they can be conditioned, learned, and you can focus on the matter at hand. Greed can be beaten, contained, controlled. You know it better than anyone, or I hope you do. It doesn't matter. Everyone asks that, should be asking how they plan on leaving. It only takes putting a collar on one to begin the chain. One with a collar may chain another, and that one another had traps all over the wastes. The chain ends with a super mutant. Although with him, the collar wasn't even necessary. He only needed guidance. The mutant. He swallowed one of the collars. After that, he was mine. A collar wasn't even necessary. All his kind, they exist to be given orders. They're soldiers, simple, stupid. I asked him to fetch, and he did, even without the threat of death. Even when I stopped speaking to him, he continued to leave the villa, gather victims from the man traps out of habit. He must have found you in one of them. If so, he's probably forgotten. He only remembers my voice. He put the collar on you, dragged you here, because he doesn't know any better. It's in his nature, greedy and childlike. Dog? Appropriate. It's what I called him. You've met him. You know why he forgot. His brain was ruined by FEV. His memory, wreckage. He may know the way back somewhere. Deep down, I doubt it. He tracks by smell and instinct. Still, he could be trained. Of course, I walked all this way. If you're worried, I'll give you a map back or show you the way out when this is all over.
Ask. You still have time.
It started with a setback. Fires, blood. Beneath the sun. A sun so close you could touch it. Moments like that, however, failures, can provide the brightest clarity. After that, I wandered alone. Saw the storms of the divide. Walked among the ciphers of the west. Traveled to the big empty. I heard the signal. The woman's voice, the Sierra Madre, promising a chance to begin again, reverse my fortunes. All nonsense. I tracked the signal, came here, scouted the city, using other hands, kept dying on me, killing each other. You got the farthest of all. The callers, they're pre-war tech. I suspect this great land had compliance issues before the war. It's one of a series of models. The one in your neck? Special. Easier to make adjustments. Unreliable in other ways, notably radio interference. A place far from here called the Big Empty. Almost didn't make it out. There were two others there. A woman. And a man, a courier. The woman was familiar. I don't know what happened to him. Big Empty's a treasure box, a scientific graveyard of old world misery. Like the Sierra Madre, there's treasures there, sleeping. Some awake. The holo rifle, the Saturnite alloy, the hologram technology, hibernation chambers, securitrons, the collars. Even the suits attached to those things, stalking the villa. That's only the surface of what's there. Right now, the Sierra Madre is what I want.
Ask.
No. I'm not going to take the chance while I'm so close. Not this close. No. Not again. I can wait. Afford to be careful. You? You're locked down there. This is the only entrance, and I have free reign of the Sierra Madre. I have time. More than you. Besides, there might be more traps. I'll send more scouts in. Yes, others. You're resourceful. Don't want to leave anything more to chance. don't think so. It'd most likely trigger other security measures, if you hurt the vault at all. The builder of the casino built it to last. The Sierra Madre withstood the war. I'm sure the vault is protected as well. Besides, you wouldn't have followed the signal if you didn't want this place's secrets for your own. You're curious, past the threats. The collar? Even if you could trigger it, no, you'd die. Kill yourself, and you decide this now. I can shut down your signal, prevent the collar from going off. Huh. Clever.
Whoever designed the Sierra Madre, their obsession with messing with frequencies and signals. I'm coming down. I'll meet you face to face at the vault entrance. If you resist, I'll use the collar, even if it puts the vault at risk.
What's this? Alarms. What? You think you can run? This entire structure is mine to command. Security, weapons, all. You think you've outsmarted me? You're the one on the leash. You always were.
You've heard stories of the Sierra Madre Casino. We all have. You've heard stories of the Sierra Madre Casino. We all have. This story's different than the others. It's all in promise of beginnings and the ending.
Dog forgot himself, as did the voice that raged within him. After their passing, a new voice spoke within the mutant shell. It was difficult for the voice to remember the two it once was. There was the beast, Dog, consumed by hunger. And the other, in reverse, the one consumed by control. Both were driven by need for the other. The courier brought them together somehow, joined the two into one. All that happened at the Sierra Madre was a faint memory to the new personality, like a flickering light in the clouds of the mind. The new voice did not think of the courier again until the battle at the Divide reached his ears. The battle between the two couriers, beneath the torn skies and the old world flag, each bearing a message for the other. And the mutant prayed the courier that had saved him had been saved in return.
Dean Domino, entertainer, singer, thief, explored the Sierra Madre not long after he was rescued by the courier. Once he left the theater, the Sierra Madre recognized him as a guest, and many doors opened to him. He had to admit it had been built to last. During his search, he came across the final records of Vera and Sinclair and realized what happened the night the bombs fell. He felt strangely sad for a moment, and he had no idea why. Shrugging it off, his mind turned instead to where the courier had come from. Vegas still survived, out there in the Mojave. Its sights, sounds, and casinos, ripe for the taking. So, giving the Sierra Madre one last nod and a wink, he set off beyond the cloud to begin again.
Christine, her mission complete, found new purpose as the Sierra Madre's warden. She watched over it silently, by choice. Over time, the ghost people came to see her as one of the holograms. They would watch, silently, as she walked among them. At times, Christine thought of the courier, who had kept Elijah's hand from her throat. The courier reminded her of the other courier she had met in the Big Empty, and wondered if the two had found each other at last. She did not think of them again until she heard the legends of the Divide. The Divide, where the two messengers, the two couriers, fought beneath an ancient flag at the edge of the world.
You've heard of the Sierra Madre Casino.
We all have. The legend, the curses.
Some foolishness about it lying in the middle of a city of dead.
A city of ghosts.
Beneath a blood-red cloud.
A bright, shining monument, reaching out, luring treasure hunters to their doom. An illusion.
A promise that you can change your fortunes. Begin again.
Finding it, though. That's not the hard part. It's letting go.
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 Those who will care for you, to those who know these joys, the Sierra Madre holds.